Hello, Pottery Pals. This is Robert Briggs, and you're watching the Pottery Pod for February 12th, 2011. I've had some requests to do a couple of extra episodes this month, and so we're going to continue with our previous episode on how to throw off the hump. This episode, I'm just going to simply do a real quick little general purpose bowl that you can use for anything. And so we've got our hump of clay that we started with. We actually pulled up on this hump of clay, and it's still a little you know, sturdy, so we're going to go ahead and clean it up a little bit more here. And I'm just going to continue as if we were just continuing off what we did with the bottle. I'm going to go ahead and dig a little well with my fingertip, as again, this clay is really soft and easy to manipulate, so I'm running the wheel really fast. And I'm going to just use this knuckle right here underneath and kind of define how much clay I'm going to use on this little bowl. And that's about a bowl by itself right there. I'm going to go ahead and stabilize the inside with my left hand, and I'm going to use this knuckle. I'm going to pull out kind of 45 degrees right here with this first pull, just enough to kind of define the shape and to start leveling out the clay. Then I'm going to go ahead and take my finger and smooth out the inside to get more of a bowl-like shape on the inside. And I go ahead and define more with my fingertips and just go ahead and pull again to about 45 or 30 degrees and get kind of a triangle shape. I'm just kind of pulling outward instead of upward into the volcano shape you normally do when you throw pottery. This one's kind of reversed from that. So I just keep taking my knuckle and balancing with the fingers on the inside and throw another ring of clay. And when I get to the top, I'm going to leave this big thick lip right there. And we'll define that lip as the edge or the lip of our little bowl here. Eventually, I'll go ahead and take this tool, this wooden rib, and I'm going to define an area at the bottom where the foot will be. And I'm going to go ahead and just smooth out the finger rings and level it out a little bit, kind of get rid of a little bit of the wobble because the clay is very soft. And once I get rid of the finger rings and smooth it out, get more of a bowl-like shape, basically all I'm doing is pushing with my hand on the inside until I actually touch the rib. The rib's not doing much except sitting there and supporting my hand movements from the inside. I'm going to go ahead and define that lip a little bit more, work the edge a little bit more. And now what I think I'm going to do is just go ahead and smooth out the our lip. It's fine the way it is, but smooth out the lip a little bit, and I'm going to take the chamois that we used in the last episode, and I'm just going to go ahead and let the clay run through the chamois and smooth it out a little bit so that it's a nice clean edge. It'll make a really glass smooth edge with the glaze when the glaze gets done. And what you've got basically is your bowl. I'm going to take out some water from the inside, and then I'm going to take a curved rib. I'll take this curved rib and just one of the sides or the other, and I'll go ahead and support and runaway sponge. Go ahead and support the clay from the outside, and I'm going to go ahead and take the inside and just push out just slightly while this wheel runs pretty fast, and define the inside of the bowl, because the bowl primarily needs to have a very definite interior. The interior needs to be clean. And because we've smooshed out our edge near our foot a little bit, I'm going to go ahead and take the wooden rib here and just go ahead and redefine that shape. You know, lean over, check out the profile. I've got a mirror on the other side, so it's easy to look at also. And then I'm going to go ahead and wipe my hands off, and I think that's pretty much it right there. We'll go ahead and take our wire tool, and this time I will spin the wheel just a little bit so I can define where the foot's going to be, and eventually once that dries up, becomes leather hard, you can trim it. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you soon.